Timbo out and about this afternoon between 3 and 4, and Tommy Vance with you at 4 o'clock.
94.9 GLR. Goodbye Radio London, hello Greater London Radio, the capital's first new station for 15 years. It promises music radio for adults and aims to capture listeners in the 25 to 45 age group who it feels get a raw deal on the airwaves now. Former Radio 1 DJs Johnny Walker and Tommy Vance are part of the new lineup, which station boss Matthew Bannister says will offer an intelligent mix of speech and music.
I think we're coming into a gap in the market where people aren't being served in London. And it's a gap between, say, Radio 1 on the one hand, where you get disc jockeys who prattle between records, and Radio 2 on the other hand, where people feel we really haven't grown into Val Dunican yet. And we're going to come right through the middle of that, and I don't think there is competition for that slot.
Less than a mile away, Capital Radio is also changing.
At the end of November, we're launching Capital Gold.
Chairman Sir Richard Attenborough tells listeners that from November the 28th, the station is doing the splits. Its Capital Gold service of golden oldies, now only at weekends, will go out 7 days a week on medium wave, with the top 40-led mix of music and speech staying on FM. This current rash of changes is in part a response to the continued success of pirate stations, of which there are dozens in London, staying on the air despite repeated raids. It's also the forerunner to a radio explosion. London's three existing radio stations could be joined next year by some of the 20 new community stations planned by the IBA. A decision's expected in the next few weeks. In 1990, as part of the big TV and radio shake-up, there'll be a new radio authority. One of its first jobs to assign frequencies for up to 500 new community stations, with a large slice of them going to London, where there's been most demand. Three commercial networks could also be on the air by then.
I think for listeners it's going to be a new age, and it's going to be tremendous excitement for them. And I think it will put radio back on the map and give radio the sort of impetus that it lost when television arrived.
Radio has a very special place, and I think in a way, when there is this going to be this multiplicity of choice in television, I think people are going to adhere to a particular radio station that they feel they can rely upon at particular times of the day. No, I think radio has a marvellous future.